Welcome, friends. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. Today, we're going to do another cocktail out of this 1937 printing of Café Royal cocktail book. This is a cocktail book compiled by Jay Tarling of recipes from bars and hotel lounges across England. And some of the recipes are his own, and some of them he attributes to other bartenders, like the one we're going to do today called Atlantic, invented by H. Lasapio. Now, a lot of people have said you're tired of watching me make gin drinks. So today we're going to make a drink that features rum with some gin in it. So we're going to start out with this Diplomatico rum. It is an 8-year-old rum that's apparently very good for mixing. So I'm going to use that in both cocktails. Next in is the same amount of Cointreau. And then it calls for dry gin. So I'm gonna use my favorite dry gin, this Dylan's gin, and it's made with a rye base. I really like the flavor. So we're gonna use that. And then about a month ago, we did a virtual tasting online with Bombay Sapphire. So I'm gonna try that in a cocktail and see if we like it. And then the last ingredient is a dash of absinthe. So each one gets a dash of absinthe. And we'll ice each of the mixing glasses. And give it a stir. Okay. A couple of cocktail glasses iced down and ready to go. And so this is the one with the Dylan's. And this is the one with the Bombay Sapphire. The Atlantic.
Ah, very oceanic.
Yes.
Hey, friends. Hey, Glen.
I don't know why it's called the Atlantic. It's got rum in it. Rum comes from the Caribbean, which is kind of adjacent to the Atlantic.
I don't know.
So, this one is made with Dylan's gin.
Okay.
And that one's made with Bombay Sapphire.
Okay.
So, let's give them a go.
Ooh. That's a fairly pleasant drink.
I like that.
I'm surprised. I'm not a big rum fan, so I'm kind of surprised at how that all works out. I mean, everybody has things they like.
That's really nice. So there's a really good... Let's try the opposite ones. Let's see.
All right.
What do you think?
This is where I get into trouble, where I taste back and forth, and suddenly you've had too many. I actually like this one a little better.
Do you?
Yeah, I like the one with the Bombay Sapphire better.
I like the one with the Dylan's better.
That's great. We don't have to share.
We don't have to share. So, I...
Although I will say there's an odd banana flavor to me.
Okay.
Which I was surprised about, because that's not a flavor you get, but it's very pleasant, sweet. That pleasant sweetness of a banana. Like, not like, wah, it's a banana.
It's really balanced. So the absinthe doesn't overtake the Cointreau. It's not oversweet. There's a good balance of flavors in both of them. I would drink both of them.
And there's something about the combination. It has a lovely texture to it,
too. Yeah, it's really nice.
Yeah.
There's something about rye that I really enjoy in that gin.
There is a subtle difference between the two.
This
and I think this one is just...
Softer?
I find this one a little more refreshing, is how I would say.
So this one's softer. This one... challenges you a bit and says, hey, I'm here. But I think they're both really good. I think we found a winner. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.